So, why do people get pissed off? Angry. Why do I get pissed off? Some people believing in hell. For example, it's like I'm going, okay. People are believing in hell and they say, you're going to go to hell for cussing. You're going to go to hell for this and that and the other thing. So they're using their belief system about hell to try to make you feel wrong, bad, or guilty, or make me feel wrong, bad, and guilty. So, am I really getting pissed off about them believing in what they believe about hell existing, or am I getting pissed off because they're using their belief to make me feel wrong, bad, or guilty? And go, well, let me look at that. When people feel wrong, it doesn't feel good. They don't like it. People like to be right. They like to feel right. It's a very important thing in a being's life, this thing about right and wrong. Most people, a psychopath, they're not into right and wrong. They don't give a shit. There is no right, there is no wrong. It's about the end justifying the means. It's about getting what they want. It's about doing what they want to do and getting the fuck away with it. It's power. Power is above their idea of right and wrong. Not just the idea, but the consideration, living by the ideas and the rules about this is right and this is wrong. It's okay to do this. You might do things that you believe are wrong. Somebody else might not believe they're wrong, but you believe they're wrong. It's wrong to do this and that and the other thing. Somebody else says, no, it's okay. And you might do something wrong for all the right reasons, but it's conflict and you feel bad. You feel guilty. You feel shame, regret, remorse. But you did it because circumstances got you in that position, or you were cornered and you had to do it. Like a Vietnam War scenario where good kids, they're 18 years old, they get forced into the military to fight somebody else's war, and they end up in Vietnam somewhere shooting innocent people. Okay, so, but they're doing it for all the right reasons. They don't want to get put in prison for treason. They don't want to go AWOL, and they don't want to ruin their life by dodging the draft. They don't want to ruin their life by getting thrown in jail in the brig for not following orders. So they have their reasons, which is their logic. So why do people get so angry? Why do I get so angry when people don't believe what I do? I think it has, and same for you. You know, if you're getting pissed off at people, and I'm not saying it's wrong to get pissed off. Hey, they don't believe what you believe. Get fucking pissed off. Have a fucking fit. It's like, Jesus, what's wrong with these fucking people, right? They don't see life as you do, and you have a reality. You know, you like there's a way the world is supposed to be, or the way the world should be. It should be kinder, lighter, nicer. The government should be more understanding and for the people instead of for themselves and for the government. Well, this has to do with the super rich power elite and the powers that be having taken over the government. Their people are in the government positions as governors, as senators, representatives, presidents, candidates for president, all that stuff. Puppets of the puppet masters. And we don't get to know who the puppet masters are until we start doing the studying. And even then, we don't know specifically who's this guy's puppet master and who's his and who's his. But it's just not right for a being that believes in truth, justice, and freedoms, and living in harmony or in balance with other beings on the planet and with nature, something doesn't seem to be right. So you have a value system of what is right, and if you have something that's, you understand is right, you have something that you understand is wrong. So you end up polarized to some degree, and as long as things are going right or right-ish, you're doing okay. And as long as you're doing what you intend to do and succeeding at it, you're winning, and winning feels good. So winning and feeling right both feel really good. So if you're winning in life and you're feeling right, you're doing great. Now, the psychopaths, the super rich power elites, the billionaires, most billionaires, I don't know if every billionaire is a fucked up piece of shit, but and that's my label for them. Their own label is they're powerful. I can imagine their label is that they're powerful, they're rich, they know what they're doing, they know why they're doing it, and they're not wrong, bad, or guilty for doing it, and they are winning in life. So they're enjoying their life, and they have their own belief systems that create their own reality. And the things that will piss them off is people going against what they believe is the right thing to do for them. And so, what else? So when I'm thinking about the heaven and hell thing and people believing in heaven and hell, I'm pissed because their belief systems are going to affect their afterlife. And I have a strong position, a belief, strong belief system, and strong values about spiritual freedom, awakening, and freedom, liberation in spirit and consciousness. Because I believe people are put here in this plane of existence, this belief, earth, physical earth right now, this earth plane that we're in right now. You can give it different labels, but it's just earth in the physical universe going around the sun. The sun's going around the galactic core. It doesn't matter. So that's not the real issue for me. This can also be a matrix, a simulated reality. This could be a dream, literally a dream. This is a dream, and when you wake up from this dream, you'll be more awake, and you go, oh my God, what a fucking nightmare. Or you go, oh, what an interesting experience that was. I'm sure glad it was just a dream. But it's not just one lifetime. It might be a million lifetimes, and you finally wake up from it. Or you don't. You just keep dreaming and dreaming and dreaming. But so this could be a mental construct or a visualization. This could be your imagination creating this world that you see, just like you would see a vivid daydream. Some people are very vivid in their imaginings, and they can see stuff crystal clear, and they can touch and feel it. And so that's very much like an out-of-body experience. When you shift consciousness, you're in a world or a realm that is not the physical universe, but it's very real, and you're wide awake and conscious. So consciousness, wide awake and aware, with a memory of what has been going on, gives one a context for being, whether it's in this universe or another. So this universe can be all these things. So what pisses me off about somebody believing in the Christian heaven and hell thing is because my beliefs are such that a person who believes in that is likely to get caught up in the reincarnational trap, the soul traps, the between lives implant stations, this whole forced reincarnation. In other words, forced back into a dream or a simulated reality or a matrix or simulation, a reality system, but a physical body once again, and mind wiped once again. So my strongest values have to do with spiritual freedom, awakening, consciousness, liberation of spirit, joy, happiness, love, life, These are really strong and important values to me. And in my belief system, in the context of how I believe life works, if somebody else believes in heaven, they're likely to drop dead and reach for that heaven afterlife realm, which I believe is laden heavily with deception and trickery and lies, that the main reason for them is to get the powerful being that you are to agree to reincarnate yet once again. So it's rubbing against my strongest values, and I want it to stop, so it's angry. So anyway, I'm just talking here about why do people get pissed off about what other people believe. So the whole thing about the flat earth business, why do people attack flat earthers? You know, they just get on there and be insulting and lame as fucking can be and insulting. And some of them are very intellectual and smart and engineering background and science background, and or even an astrophysics background, but they'll get on, they'll bash the flat earthers. why would they do that in context of what I've just been talking about? I think there's some people that they just like, they enjoy being insulting, and they have very shallow understanding of life and experience, and the flat earth thing threatens their understanding of their very limited understanding of reality and life, and they enjoy being hateful, angry, disdainful, contemptuous, insulting assholes, pricks, and dicks. They like doing that, so they do that. I think others are actually paid or influenced and working. They don't have they don't care. They're just doing it as trolls for somebody else's agenda. I think there's a lot of that going down. People are getting paid to monitor the flat earth movement. And the people that are getting paid, they're just goon squad, ignorant, you know, shallow fucking beings or trolls. While the ones that are paying them or rewarding them some way for them to be monitoring and taking shots at the flat earth movement, the ones that are doing the payoffs and their higher ups, this whole area, they do not want the human population looking into this. They don't want that. And you got to ask, well, why not? Why can't that group just let this group be and do their research and share what they know and what they've learned? You know, their laser. I love the laser experiments they do, and I love the gyroscope. You know, if theoretically, if you fly, if the earth is a globe and you have a gyroscope and it's going to stand up like this, it's not going to move its position. So if you fly over the earth around like this, it should always point this direction. But if it's a flat plane and you fly, it will still stay its same direction. So theoretically, could you just take an airplane with a lot of fuel and put two or three or four different kinds of gyroscopes in there? Just, you know, cover your bases as far as your experiment goes. You get in there and you take off flying, and you fly a certain amount of distance, even just across from LA to New York, for example, or across the Atlantic Ocean. There should be a difference. And you get, you just watch your fucking gyroscopes. What are they going to do? So you have different people saying they've done experiments like this, and I've seen both types, and you know, somebody's lying. When you get different results or different conclusions, somebody's lying or they're not observing things correctly. They're spinning it, they're doing it on purpose, or they're, you know, why is that? Why are people coming up with different stories about the gyroscope thing? I don't know, but I've watched these guys buy these gyroscopes, and they're basically all mechanical. They have an air, they're powered by air to keep it spinning. And some of them are electronic, I think, but powered. The point is, though, there's a story going around about the reason the... Let's say you start an air. Let's say the world is the globe. It's a globe. Let's say it's round, and you start out in your airplane, and you got your gyroscope sticking straight up. Okay. And they fly a distance, and they land over here. And it's still, as the world turns, it's still straight up, even though they went around the globe. If it is. If their theory or premise is that the world is a globe, and they've taken a gyroscope in an airplane and they flew around and it still shows it's straight up, they will have an explanation that there's an auto-adjust function built into the gyroscope, built into the electronics or something. That's the one video I saw that was... a gyroscope experiment that was pushing the globe Earth story. That was their conclusion or their input. And normally, if somebody's going to give you disinformation on purpose and pretend like it's not disinformation but it's legit, they will use somebody with credentials, or they will say the person has credentials. And they would be in the know. So they're an authority on this. I'm a pilot, blah, 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 or I'm an engineer and I build these gyroscopes. I install them in the airplanes. They would tell us, they would say that this, it's got a built-in autocorrect function in it. And that's why it always stays. If it starts out perpendicular, and you go halfway around the world, it's still perpendicular. It's because it has an autocorrect function in it. Well, the first time I heard that one, I go, I don't fucking think so, motherfucker. I really don't believe that one. So again, it gets down to beliefs. And now I'm pissed off again because my values, even if it's not true, but I believe it's true, so it's my truth, you know. But it's what I understand to be true. If that's being threatened, or if somebody says no, 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 then I'm being made wrong. And when I'm being made wrong, it can piss me off. You can be very tolerant of being wrong and like, eh, right, wrong, who gives a fuck? Good on you. But most of us, most humans, do not like being wrong, and we will get an emotional response to it. If you're more uptone, if you're emotionally stronger in a good position relative to the people around you, and somebody makes you wrong, you're able to feel strong about it and feel confident and proud. No, you're fucking full of shit, and you can walk away feeling proud. If you're feeling a little more threatened, and they keep at you, keep coming at you, no, 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 you're wrong, you're wrong, you're wrong, you're going to say, hey, shut the fuck up, motherfucker. It's going to piss you off. If you're less strong or less confident in your position as relative to right and wrong, whether it's a flat earth, globe earth, NASA lies, 9/11 was an inside job, chemtrails are not good for you, and why, and the New World Order, super rich power elite, and all this suppression going on, puppet masters, and the Pope being monitored, not monitored, but controlled by dark entities, archons. If you're going, yeah, and somebody else is going, no, and yeah, fuck you, or it's important to you, and you can get angry about it, because the person you're talking to is unwilling to look unwilling, ignoring all the things that are important to you. It's important to know whether your government's lying to you. It's important to know that 9/11 was an inside job. It's important to know these things.